Hi lovelies, it's me, Simply Sherry, making home and entertaining simple. Today I'm going to share with you my top three tips on how to host a dinner party.
I want to thank Louis Jadot for sponsoring this video.
I already drink their wine, so I'm excited to share with you my perfect pairings with Louis Jadot wines.
I love entertaining, especially in the fall when the temperatures here in Arizona roll out of the 110s and into cooler weather. Today I am setting up a dinner for six of us and I'm going to be pairing wine. Don't let all the wine glasses throw you off. This is simple and easy, and I'm going to share with you three tips to help you host that wonderful dinner party with wine. My first tip is to use seasonal food and decor. For my centerpiece, I just went to my local grocery store and picked up some greenery, scented pine cones, and white mini pumpkins. You can also get things like sticks and leaves, corn, apples, acorns, flowers, anything that says the fall season, and putting it onto your table as the centerpiece really adds to the ambiance of the dinner and really welcomes in the season and welcomes your guests. For the menu, incorporate seasonal food like figs, squash, pumpkins, pomegranate, persimmon. They are accessible and they're fresh. Tip number two is to serve make-ahead dishes. For appetizers, I am serving rosemary sesame pecans. For salad, it is an arugula salad with bosque pears and crumbled goat cheese. Then I am serving for the entree pork chops with fingerling potatoes. For the rosemary sesame pecans, I just toss them in the mixture and then put them in my toaster oven. The great thing about this is after you've mixed them, you can set some aside, put it in a Ziploc, and freeze them for the next time you have dinner guests. You just pop them into the oven. The great thing with salads is that you can always prepare them ahead of time. Here I just have to cut the pears and put in the cheese and the other stuff that I'm putting into the salad. Then right before I serve it, I can just toss it in the dressing and it's ready to go. One of the easiest side dishes to serve is roasted vegetables. I've done asparagus, French beans, peppers. Today I am serving roasted fingerling potatoes. It's so easy. I just toss the potatoes in the herbs and spices and olive oil. I just make sure they're all evenly coated and I put it in the oven. After they're roasted and cooked, I can put it on a warm setting and I just leave it there until they're ready to be served. For the pork chops, I start cooking them to make sure that they are done and ready at least 20 minutes before my guests arrive, and then I can leave it in the cast iron pot in the oven on a warm setting. Again, just like the potatoes, they are ready to be served. And for dessert, I am serving these mini apple pies a la mode with vanilla bean ice cream. I got them from my specialty grocery store along with these mini Danish pastries and assorted cookies. And even if you're the one picking up the dessert, it's okay. You've already set up this beautiful table. You've cooked this wonderful dinner. You've welcomed your guests into your home. A store-bought dessert is quite all right.
My last tip is to pair one red and one white wine. I am going to be pairing this Mâcon Village Chardonnay with the arugula salad and Pinot Noir with the pork chops. And there's no need to be intimidated because Jadot has a website, lovejadot.com. And it's like having your personal sommelier. And here it is, lovejadot.com. And it's America's number one French wine. Here's a part where it just talks about Jadot and the wine, the winery. And then it has the different wines, which I found very, very helpful. So here you can see all the wines that they offer. Look at this. There even is a tab on how to say it.
Maison Louis Jadot, Mâcon Village.
Isn't that fun? With the salad that I am serving, I saw here on the Mâcon Village Chardonnay that it has this little short blurb about the grapes and the wine itself. And then it has here just short descriptions about the tasting note, food pairing, points of distinction, and about the grape. So here, the tasting note, it's floral, apple and citrus aromas and fresh, clean flavors with mineral notes. So I thought that would go great with the arugula salad. So here it even says food pairing poultry, seafood, or salads. You get to know a little bit more about the wine, and then it really helps your overall understanding of how this wine pairs with that salad. The other great thing about lovejadot.com is that there is a wine locator, and you can choose which wine you want to find, or you can choose all products. Put in your zip code, click submit.
Then it will show a list of all the local grocery stores, big box stores, warehouse stores, and retailers in your area.
Personally, I first tried Jadot a while back because of the pretty label. Then I saw that it's a French wine and I liked the price. So I said yes, and no wonder it's America's number one French wine. It's quality French wine that's accessible. So if you know a little bit about wine but want to open up your palate a little bit more, try Jadot. Or if you are nervous about entertaining and what wine to bring out, Jadot helps us out. lovejadot.com. I encourage you to go to their website. It's like having a personal sommelier. Please leave a comment below and let me know what's your perfect pairing with Jadot. I hope you enjoyed this video of my three tips on how to host a dinner party. Number one, use seasonal food and decor. Number two, serve make-ahead dishes. And number three, pair one red and one white wine. If you're new to my channel, hit the subscribe button and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!